Dear students, I am going to explain here a physics practical. So let's go for experiment number one. The object or aim of the experiment number one is to determine the diameter of a glass rod with the help of vernier calipers. For vernier calipers, we need theory. So in the theory, we will be discussing here how to get pitch, how to get least count, how to get reading. So here in observation, we will be taking value of one main scale division. Here one main scale division is 1 millimeter. 1 millimeter can be considered, can be calculated as 0.1 centimeter. Now for second observation, number of divisions on vernier scale, we have noticed there are 10 divisions on the vernier scale. So easily can calculate least count by dividing to x by n. Here 0.1 means pitch by number of divisions on vernier scale. So here least count equals to 0.01 centimeter.
Let me explain the vernier caliper, the different parts of the vernier caliper. Here there are two pairs of jaws. These two jaws are called internal jaws. These two jaws are called external jaws, because these two jaws are used to find out the diameter of a glass rod or pen's cap, etc. Now here there is a tail. This tail is used to measure the depth of a narrow tube. Now in this vernier scale, there are two scales, main scale and vernier scale. In the main scale, it is graduated in centimeter. Again, 1 centimeter is divided by 10 divisions. So each small division is 1 millimeter, means 0.1 centimeter. That is called pitch. Now, in vernier scale, there are 10 divisions. Are you able to see this one? There are 10 divisions. Okay. Now, there is a screw. This screw is used to move the vernier scale as well as one of the external jaws and one of the internal jaws. And there is another screw. That screw is here to fix the vernier scale when we are going to get the reading. Look here, to measure the external diameter of the glass rod, I have kept the glass rod in between the two external jaws. Right? Now let's have a look the main scale reading. Here main scale reading is 0.6 centimeter, right? And vernier's division, fourth division, is coinciding one of the graduation of the main scale. Have a look, fourth division of the vernier scale is coinciding with the one of the graduation of the main scale. So here VSD is 4. Right? So let's go to observation table.
Here main scale reading is 0.6 centimeter, and we have noticed vernier scale division is 4. So reading is 0.6 plus 4 into 0.01 is equal to 0.64, right?
Since the rod may not be uniform, so for mean diameter, let's put the vernier scale in different position of the rod. And now have a look the reading of main scale as well as vernier scale. Here again, in the main scale, we have noticed the reading of the main scale is again 0.6 centimeter. And here vernier scale is coinciding on third position. Okay. Third division of the VSD is coinciding on the main scale graduation. So here VSD is 3.
So main scale reading again 0.6 centimeter. And vernier scale division, means VSD, is here 3. So reading is 0.6 plus 3 into 0.01 is equal to 0.63 centimeter. Hello students, meanwhile I have taken two more readings. Third reading is 0.6 main scale reading and vernier scale division 4. So reading is 0.6 plus 4 into 0.01 equals to 0.64 centimeter. And for the fourth observation, again I have got main scale reading 0.6 and vernier scale division again 4. So reading will be again 0.64. Okay, this is the observation table. From this observation table, we are going to find out mean reading, means that will be the diameter of the glass rod. So to get the mean reading, you have to add all these 4 readings and divide by 4. So we got here 0.64 centimeter. Make sure that we should put the unit at the end. So diameter of the glass rod is here 0.64 centimeter. Thank you.